Action Alliance, Barrister Ken Udeze, who is
who have credible intelligence that the design of the grand plot to delay the 2019 general election has been completed and implementation has accordingly commenced. It is more worrisome that the government towing this path of dishonor is a government that won an election where the people were allowed to cast their vote freely and their votes were allowed to count. It is now about 28 days since the National Assembly forwarded to the President and for the fourth time necessary amendment to our Electoral Act. The President has not signed the amendment. We also sad to say this to you, that there is intelligence that the President has agreed with his kitchen cabinet not to sign the amendment into law. We have been informed that after several undue delays, the President is set to communicate to the National Assembly anytime from today that he will not be able to sign the amendment due to the existence of Article 2 of the ECOWAS Protocol on Democracy and Good Governance, which prohibits countries from making electoral act amendments less than 6 months to election unless there is consent of the political parties. How convenient for President Buhari, who has severally disregarded and disobeyed the ECOWAS court, to suddenly begin to obey ECOWAS protocol and not sign an amendment first sent to him in February 2018. This is the completion of a process completely done by the National Assembly within the constitutionally allowed timeline and the ECOWAS protocol. This amendment that the President has refused to sign yet was done within time. The political parties were all carried along and their input sought. Hence, the ECOWAS protocol cannot avail him. A president who has severally marted what he supposedly suffered from rigged election and how an improved electoral process benefited him in 2015 is now the greatest antagonist to free and fair election. The foundation to free and fair elections is strong institutions and credible laws, both of which the president has ensured we do not have. Gentlemen of the press, it is disheartening that our president is in Poland frolicking. That is what it is. He visited the Bukana Memorial and Museum Center in Poland, which includes Nazi concentration camps, a place devoted to the memory of victims who died during the World War II. This president has not visited any military burial ground in Nigeria in honor of our slain soldiers since he came to power. Neither has he attended any of their burial ceremony. This president has not visited the Kaduna mass grave, where peaceful Shiite protesters were massacred and buried. There is no difference between the Jewish victim of the Nazi invasion of Poland and the Shiite buried in Kaduna mass grave. How hypocritical is it to visit such sites in Poland in an attempt to mellow the global media backlash he suffered and ignore all the local memorial sites at home? Why would you not ordinarily believe that it is not the real Buhari, but one Jubri that is in the villa? However, we align ourselves with the views that the rumors that is being fueled by the crushed incompetence and lack of capacity exhibited by the president, which is in clear contrast with the Buhari with character whom Nigeria voted in 2015. Many Buhari they knew in 2015 who declared that he belonged to everyone and belonged to no one is the same person dividing Nigeria along ethnic and religious line 95% over 5%. And is beating the worst level of nepotism in appointment of head of security agencies. Hence, President Buhari best way to prove to Nigerians he spoke to in Poland that he's not cloned is to come home as a true Nigerian leader and sign the 2018 amended electoral bill into law. However, all credible intelligence have revealed that after a damage control meeting held in Abuja, key leaders of the ruling party, including Abubakar Malami, Rotimi Amaechi, Asiwaju Bola Tinubu, Governor Yahaya Bello, Ahmed Lawan, Adams Oshimole, Governor Ahmed Erufai, Governor Omar Ganduje, and a head of a security agency have concluded and also have informed the president that the amendment should not be signed. The amendment, if signed into law, makes the use of the card reader statutory and the only instrument of accreditation, thereby permanently doing away with the incident forms. The amendment takes care of the issue of exclusion of political parties from election. The amendment also makes the back-end result of the card reader an evidential tool can be that can be called upon for nullifying an election where certain levels of infraction currently allowed in our election are perpetrated. If the amendment is not signed into law, there is fear by Nigerians that the election will end up the most violent election in our recent history, as victory will be for only those who shoot themselves through the ballot, as the hand of the Supreme Court will be tied for nullifying the election because of the non-statutory backing of the Kadrida, as have been heard in some 2015 election cases decided by the Supreme Court. Nigerians are hereby reminded that out of the 7.1 million votes scored by President Muhammad Buhari in Northwest in 2015, over 5.6 million of the votes in the so-called famed stronghold of the president were through incident forms and without the use of Kadrida for accreditation. Kano had 1.5 million that was not accredited, Katsina 1 million, Kaduna 800,000, Jigawa 744,000, Sokoto 588,000, Zamfara 578,000, and Kebbi 496,000. It shows that about a third of the about 15 million votes which President Muhammad Buhari used to win the 2019 election, we have 2015 election, we have votes that did not go through the Kadrida from the Northwest. The use of incident form allowed for unqualified, unregistered, and illegal immigrants to participate in the elections. Nigerians cannot see the real reason why the president does not want to sign the amendment. The least President Buhari can do an awful performance in almost can do after an awful performance in almost 4 years is to leave Nigerians with an enabling legal framework to freely and credibly conduct elections going forward. The plot to destabilize elections in 10 states. The presidency, believing that it will cross this stage of the plot not to sign the electoral act and reintroduce the use of incident forms, has set in motion plots to fine-tune the next stage, which will be to militarize the elections and destabilize it in at least 10 target states, including Rivers State, plot headed by Rotimi Amaechi; Delta State, plot headed by Senator Vio Omaegege; Akwa Ibom, plot headed by Senator Godswill Akpabio; Abia State, plot headed by Chief Chukwu Emeka Nwogu; Edo State, plot headed by Comrade Adams Oshomole; Imo State, plot headed by Senator Hope Uzodinma; Anambra State, plot headed by Chief Chris Ngige; Kwara State, plot headed by Alhaji Lai Mohammed; Plateau State, plot headed by Governor Simeon Lalong; Benue State, plot headed by Senator George Akume. The plot in River State, as had earlier been outlined by Governor Nyesom Wike, will include planting of guns in certain strategic places, which will warrant the compromised SARS commander, Mr. Akin Fakorode, to move in and arrest leaders of the PDP in River State. This militarization will lead to canceling presidential and governorship elections in the above-mentioned states and more, especially where the president knows he will lose woefully and rerun election conducted so that talks and state apparatus will be deployed on a separate day to massively intimidate voters and eventually rig the presidential election and the governorship election in those states. This dastardly plot includes the fact that there will be little or no policing of the Northwest geographical zone. Talks have a few days and record bloated figures for him as usual without the use of the card reader. The opposition neutralization formula and code 20. Gentlemen of the press, but the bad news which the regime did not reckon with is the resilience of the Nigerian people to resist a bad government and ensure it is voted out of power. They will be disappointed and their enterprise will be frustrated. Even in the Northwest, the president will realize that the Nigerian people are united to send him packing to Daura. The presidency will be shocked that this political evil forest into which they are leading Nigerians will not save them from the impending massive political defeat. The common will of the Nigerian people to reclaim their country from the worst level of economic hardship and recklessness will triumph. Nigerians and the opposition shall not sit idly any longer and watch the ruling APC destroy our hard-earned democracy. We are no longer calling on the international community to intervene. We shall save our people, for we carry the burden of their hope for a great Nigeria. The presidency had modified the same ignoble political maneuvers which truncated both the First and Second Republics following the 1963 and the 1983 general election. It was the executive impunity and widespread electoral manipulation that led to the collapse of both First and Second Republics. God forbid that our republic collapses because of President Muhammad Buhari's desperation. It is to this extent that the opposition has resolved, and we are here to brief you today of this resolution, that where President Muhammad Buhari fails to sign the amended electoral bill, the Nigerian opposition shall be left with no other option but to adopt and launch as the only means of survival of our democracy, the opposition code 12, the opposition code 20. This code is as enshrined in section 20 of the Administration of Criminal Justice Act, which allows citizens to perform policing duties of arrest. That section provides that a private person may arrest a suspect in Nigeria who in his presence commits an offense or whom he reasonably suspects of having committed an offense for which the police is entitled to arrest without a warrant. Hence, having seen the return of the infamous Sunday that we see of the 1983 in the form of the current Inspector General of Police, we shall now save our country. We shall not abandon our country and go home. Having seen that the only hope of President Buhari to return to power is outright purchase of votes and intimidation of voters through the use of institution of state and state-backed talks, the opposition code 20 is a neutralization strategy that will check the mayhem and violence being plotted by President Muhammad Buhari party and rein them in. We shall be mobilizing our people when it starts in all the villages and wards to stop any person seen sharing money in the police unit and retrieve such money as empowered by section 20. All the thugs and militia clothed to deceive and intimidate the people will be grabbed and handed over to the police. The opposition cannot allow them to thwart the will of the people. It shall be a show of gallantry, patriotism, heroism, and nationalism by our brothers and sisters who will stand in defense of the true values of our people as reflected in the ballot. Politicization of the security agencies. For the first time in our political history, our military service chiefs are attending campaign functions organized by the president and the ruling APC party, while Boko Haram is expanding its territory and killing hundreds of our soldiers. The Inspector General of Police is chasing only leading opposition figures, with armed robbery, kidnapping, and all sorts of crimes are now on, well, all sorts of crimes are now on the increase. The chairman of the EFCC, who sits illegally, is busy supporting campaign programs of the president, while corruption has taken over every facet of our public service, and he has no response to it. Today, the biggest looters of our national treasury are the closest friends of President Muhammad Buhari, and he wines and dines with them. The Inspector General of Police is in arrest to surpass the despicable role of Sunday Adewusi, who was Inspector General of Police in 1983. And in that time, he was otherwise known as the MPN youth leader because of his inglorious romance with the MPN government. Federal forces were used to attempt to impose the lives of Collins Obi as governor in Imo State against a performing Simon Bakwe, Sisi Olajuwon Obodo, Omobori in Ondo against a legendary Pa Ajasim, and others in other states. The discretion of our sacred institutions of state, which holds us together, is unending. We have never gone this low before. These political invaders are in Akwa Ibom attempting to use five former lawmakers to impeach a speaker and a governor in a 26-state House of Assembly. They are in River State using the act in Fakara Delet SARS to steal the rights of the people. They are in Kwara, Benue, Kogi, Imo, and so on. Opposition passes vote of no confidence on the Inspector General of Police and rejects extension for him. The opposition have been informed of ongoing moves to extend the service of the Inspector General of Police, who is due to retire on 15 January 2019, to allow him reenact the infamous 1983 police-backed electoral fraud. Let it be known to President Muhammad Buhari that any such move shall not augur well for the credibility of the electoral process, and it will weaken the institution of the police. The president is hereby put on notice that any attempt to extend the service of the Inspector General of Police beyond the 15 January 2019 retirement date shall be resisted within the ambit of the law, as any such act will be viewed by Nigerians as tantamount to hiring a machinery to help him rig his way into office. Scientific rigging, plot to prerogue candidates, pressure and INEC, and plot to reintroduce the incident form. The opposition has also been informed of the plot to attempt to secure the collaboration of INEC to make card readers available for preloading to the APC, who will use the already collected PVC numbers generated during the controversial trader money cash for vote policy headed and supervised by the Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, where they have allegedly paid 10,000 naira each for these PVCs. These numbers will be inputted into the clone PVCs and used for preloading of the card reader. There is also information pressure by the presidency and the APC to fine-tune arrangement to restore the use of incident form where the use of candidate affairs as against the repeat of election where the machine fails. The presidency should know that this collaboration is dead on arrival and cannot succeed. We hereby urge the INEC chairman to insist where the president refused to sign the Electoral Act Amendment that candidate accreditation should be the only form of accreditation in 2019 election as experimented and applauded in the Kitchener Oshun election. No other form of accreditation should be allowed, and any other form of accreditation other than the candidate will not be accepted by the opposition. Plot to arrest opposition leaders and illegal withdrawal from our national coffers. Another component part of this plot is the compilation of list of opposition leaders who will be arrested on trumped-up charges. The allegation, even after being granted bail by a court. But Nigerians will not be deterred in their resolve to send a dictator out of office for the good of Nigeria and her citizens. The regime has also failed to give account of enormous sums of money running into trillions, which it had illegally withdrawn from our nation's coffers, which has obviously been warehoused for buying of votes in February. Billions have been missing from NNPC, LNG, NEMA, etc. Nigerians are daily seeing the exposure of lies and propaganda, which they have been ruled for almost 4 years now. Lastly, we hereby put agents of this regime on notice that we have resolved to seek the help of the US, UK, and EU to place visa ban on these enemies of democracy so that they will not escape justice and judgment if they plunge Nigeria into crisis. Nigerians and the international community are hereby notified that the claim by President Buhari to allow a free and fair election is without any commitment, and it's like believing that India Amin will respect human rights. Thank you all for coming.